So this Pavlov idea actually is more general than just the prisoner's dilemma or iterated prisoner's dilemma, and in fact led to a result that I like to call the computational folk theorem. The idea of the computational folk theorem says that you give me any two-player bi-matrix game,
What's a bi-matrix game?
just that there's two players.
Sure. Okay.
So it seems kind of redundant, doesn't it?
It does.
What makes it bi-matrix as opposed to a two-player zero-sum game, which you can write down with a single matrix? This is like each player has its own reward matrix.
I see.
But you're right. I could have just said bi-matrix game and left out the two-player. And it's an average reward repeated game. So we're going to play round after round after round, and we're going to look at the average reward. Or you can also think of it as discounted with an extremely high discount factor.
Okay.
So you give me one of those games, and what I can do is I can build a Pavlov-like machine for any of these games, and use that to construct a subgame perfect Nash equilibrium for any of these games in polynomial time. So,
Wow.
and the way that this works is, if it is possible for us to have some kind of mutually beneficial relationship, then I can build a Pavlov-like machine quickly. If not, then the game is actually zero-sum-like, right? Because in a zero-sum game, we can't mutually benefit, so we can't do anything like Pavlov. We're just going to beat each other up. So we can actually solve a linear program in polynomial time and work out what the strategies would be if we're playing a zero-sum-like game. And so either that works and produces a Nash equilibrium, and we can test that, or it doesn't work, but at most one player can improve its behavior. And by taking that best response against what the other player does in a zero-sum-like sense, then that will be a Nash equilibrium. So there's three possible forms of the Nash equilibrium, but we can tick through these, figure out which one is right, and derive the actual strategies in polynomial time.
Wow, that's pretty impressive. Who came up with this idea?
So this is a result due to Peter Stone and somebody. Oh yeah, me.
Ah, well, that's very impressive. So you managed to find a way to sneak in some of your own work into this class.
Here, let's do some more of that.
Okay, I'm a big fan. And I think that's fair because I did that way back when on Mimic.
Mimic. So yeah, so w the last topic that I, this is that's all I really wanted to say about the folk theorem and repeated games. What I'd like to do now is move to stochastic games, which is a generalization of repeated games, and talk a little bit about how this relates back to things like Q learning and MDPs.
Oh, okay. That sounds cool. Almost sounds like you're wrapping up.
It is that, and that will be the end of the new material.
Wow. But that means we're coming towards the end of the entire course.
I know we're gonna all cry with disappointment, and I think, and I just say this, as an idle suggestion, that the students should demand that we teach more classes.
I concur. So let's get there so that they can demand.